Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Ninzao.co. Order flow has long been a favorite tool among traders who rely on volume and market insight to make informed decisions. However, traditional order flow versions often fall short, providing limited information and not nearly enough depth for today's trading demands. Understanding these challenges, we have upgraded order flow to version 2.0, introducing features that have never been seen before on NinjaTrader 8. But today, we won't spend too much time talking about the technology behind it. Instead, let's jump straight into how to use Order Flow 2.0 in real trading through practical and easy-to-follow examples. First, let's take a look at the following scenario. Price is moving into two key levels generated by Order Flow presentation. These levels were created when buy volume significantly exceeded sell pressure and pushed above the average volume threshold for that specific trading day. This tells us that these two zones previously showed strong buying interest, making them potential reaction areas when the market comes back to retest them. Next, let's take a closer look at the delta chart. Instead of showing just a single delta number for each candle, we've upgraded the system to analyze the full OHLC delta structure of every candle. With this enhancement, you're no longer limited to seeing whether delta is simply positive or negative. You can now observe how delta was formed throughout the candle. Whether the flow was decisive or hesitant, this gives you a much deeper and more meaningful understanding of order flow behavior compared to traditional delta charts. Now, take a look at the delta trajectory shown here. You'll notice that it resembles the structure of a typical wick rejection candle. This illustrates how buying or selling pressure shifted throughout the candle's formation, giving us a clearer picture of the underlying order flow dynamics. Looking closely, you'll notice that the delta trajectory forms a lower wick and then closes higher. This tells us that selling pressure initially appeared during the candle's formation, but that sell-side effort eventually failed. After that rejection, the delta pushed upward and closed as a green delta bar, signaling that buyers ultimately took control. Next, let's take a look at the POC of that candle. You'll notice that the POC sits near the lower part of the candle, and its orange color indicates that the sell side dominated the volume during that period. However, the candle ultimately closed bullish, which means that despite the strong selling pressure, it was absorbed completely. Buyers stepped in, overpowered the sellers, and pushed the price higher by the close. Finally, Ibushi, at the upper part of the candle, we can clearly see a strong and decisive increase in buying pressure. This makes the candle an excellent opportunity to open a buy trade, as it signals a strong transition from selling pressure to buyer dominance. After the buy signal appears, you can see that the delta trajectory continues to push upward, indicating that buying pressure remains strong and consistent. With order flow clearly favoring the buyers, you can confidently hold your buy position longer to capitalize on the ongoing bullish momentum. For the sell setup, we can observe the same type of behavior. First, we have a bullish candle with a strong positive delta, yet the price action does not reflect that strength. Instead of closing near the high, the candle closes much lower, leaving behind a long upper wick. This tells us that despite the initial buying pressure, buyers were unable to maintain control. The market pushed the price back down, revealing strong selling pressure and signaling that sellers may be stepping in and gaining dominance. Immediately after that, a strong bearish candle appears. What makes this interesting is that, similar to the earlier buy example, the delta trajectory of this candle leaves a higher upper wick, indicating that buyers attempted to step in but ultimately failed. Unlike the hesitation we saw in the previous bullish candle, this bearish candle shows clear, decisive selling pressure. When you combine this strong price action with delta confirming buyer failure, it gives us a highly reliable reason to enter a sell trade on this candle. Additionally, there is an interesting detail on this very candle. You can see multiple blue and orange dots appearing simultaneously at several price levels. This tells us that both buyers and sellers were heavily active, indicating a strong internal battle between the two sides. But ultimately, the candle closes as a solid bearish candle, confirming that the sellers won the fight. This information serves as an extra layer of confirmation, strengthening our decision to enter a sell position at this candle. This setup appears very frequently on the chart. Just like the previous example, price forms a candle with a negative delta trajectory and negative delta volume, indicating selling pressure. However, the price action does not produce a decisive bearish candle. Instead, sellers fail to push the close lower, revealing hesitation or a lack of follow-through from the sell side at that moment. After that, the market forms a candle with a delta trajectory that clearly reveals seller failure. The delta shows a lower wick, indicating that sellers attempted to push the price down, but were unable to hold control. The candle then finishes with a positive delta, signaling that buyers absorbed the selling pressure and ultimately took over. The POC also shows that sellers initially held control in the lower part of the candle as most of the trading volume concentrated near the bottom. However, the final outcome reveals that the sellers failed to maintain their dominance. Price was pushed back up, and the candle closed with clear signs of buyer strength. Similarly, in this scenario, the market behavior follows the exact same concept we just discussed. The delta trajectory here shows that buyers failed, as their initial effort wasn't strong enough to keep the price elevated. A strong bearish candle forms with the POC positioned near the top, indicating that buyers initially held control, as most of the trading activity took place at higher prices. But the deep bearish close reveals that their effort ultimately failed, and sellers took full control of the market. Join the HelloWin Forum, where Ninza family traders come together to explore valuable trading knowledge and products. Click the link in the description to get started. Thanks for watching until the end. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell icon so you don't miss our latest content.